Mickey is a small-time crook in the slums of NYC. He was stolen off the streets by an evil corporation called BGB. He is supposed to direct, and star in a video game comedy broadcast on the net. Do-do-do. With his film crew. Do-do-do. While simultaneously making up funny films that he hates, cause they're about video games. Mickey also plans his devious escapes. It's funny game jokes for kids.
I don't recall saying you faggots could watch my cartoon. What is this, Dig Dug? This is Dig Dug, right? That Dig Dug, that's a game. I don't know. I don't play video games.
Mickey, you gotta do something funny.
Oh, you want something funny? Oh, I'll give you something funny. I'll give you something funny, you little faggot. What do you think of this? Huh? What do you think of this?
Me.
Okay? How about that? How does this strike you? Does this strike you well? Does this tickle your funny bone? This is funny to you? You like this? You enjoy my humorous stylings?
2 set lights, 3 hand-painted backdrops, and 1 $3,000 digital film camera. This coupled with a blatant disregard for your responsibility to produce hilarious content for videogamevideos.com and
don't
to
know about that.
Incredibly inappropriate hostility toward don't, your film no, crew.
Yep, I don't know about that.
You're out of control, Mickey. What are you doing?
Yeah, well, I don't know about that. I don't know about that. Don't know about that. Yeah, well, I don't know about that. Don't know about that.
Why aren't you taking this seriously, Mickey?
Because I don't want to fucking do it.
We're giving you all the creative resources you need. You got all the equipment. You got a top-notch film crew.
Oh, yeah. These retards? Yeah. Real fucking top-notch.
I just want to say that you might think that I'm bad at video games because I'm a girl, but no, and I will beat you at Super Brawl Brothers if you do not believe me, and I am good at video games, and I will beat you.
Nothing prompted that. Look, I don't want to make fucking video game videos or whatever, okay? Video games are gay, okay? They're gay. They're for fucking gay, retarded, faggot babies. I think if you like video games, that might actually be, like, a signifier for, like, actually being homosexual. Or having a mental deficiency, like Down syndrome or something. And yeah, before you say anything, yes, I am likening homosexuality to having Down syndrome. Because that's the kind of guy that I am. That's the kind of guy that you have making fucking video game videos. I don't even know why am I here. Let me go!
Listen, Mickey, you're a loose cannon, and you better straighten up and fly right. We make video game videos here. That's what VGV Industries is all about. So you better get used to it.
Yeah, well, you want to know what I think about you and your company? Hey, where you guys going?
The idea was that, like, it's Mario, but, like, he's in the real world. And, like, he's, like, down on his luck. And it's all gritty and serious. And it's, like, it's funny because it's the juxtaposition of, like, the cute, lovable Mario characters, but it's, like, all gritty and real and dark. Don't you think that that would be funny?
Do I think that that would be funny? Well, I think it's funny that you think that that's funny. Hey, the clouds look exactly like the bushes. Look, clouds, bushes, clouds, bushes. Clouds. Holy shit. The clouds are the fucking bushes.
Maybe we should try a different game.
That's 23 minutes.
For 2 miles?
Nope, for 1 mile. 4 laps is 1 mile.
Oh. Is that good?
No, it is not.
Yeah, well, I fell down a couple of times.
Yeah, I saw. It was very funny. But look, you're gonna have to get a lot more speed if you want to get through this bad boy. June, wheel it in!
boy.
That was kind of wacky, I guess. Was that wacky or not? I can't tell.
Another camera, Mickey? Another one? You're out of control. What do you think you're doing out there?
Yeah, talk to the hand, old man.
You're destroying all my equipment!
Hey, boss, you know what you need to do? You need to curb your enthusiasm.
Get out of here. Get out of here.
Yeah.
Get out of here. You get the fuck out of here. What do you think you're doing? You come in here doing all this shit. You think you can tell those jokes to me? What are you doing out here like that?
You know what?
Seriously. Seriously. Get out of here. Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of my office, Mickey. I'm tired of looking at you.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? Well, you know, what do you think about this? Yeah, you like this? You like when I do this? Yeah?
You know what, Mickey? You're a dick.
You're the one who's acting like a dick. Okay, so, how about this? What if Super Mario was... Jewish? Would that be funny?
Meh, it's alright. Ooh, I hate video games so much!
Yeah, this is Game Truck, and Mickey the Dick.
Welcome to the Game Chat, where we chat about games. Today's chat member is Egoraptor, creator of Girl Paradise, and Metal Gear... Salad. Awesome. Ego, welcome to the chat. ASL.
I am 23 years old.
Of course you are. Of course you are. So, Ego, you know, a lot of these internet animator types, you know, they make these cartoons, they put them on the internet, it's, you know, it's some funny shit, and, you know, they always, you know, inject a lot of humor into their animations. Why don't you do that, Aaron? Why don't you do that?
Well, I work very hard on my cartoons, and I realize they're not to everyone's taste, but personally, I do believe that they're funny, but it's a style of humor that's not for everybody.
Well, it's cute that you think that. Hey, you hear that? Hear that ticking? It's my grandfather clock. My grandfather gave it to me. Yeah, he's dead. So, I will thank you not to make any smart remarks. Do you like my clock, Aaron?
It's nice.
What's your favorite thing about my clock?
I guess the way that it, tells the time.
Actually, the time is wrong. Should probably get that fixed. So, Aaron, my next question is, why are you gay? Why are you gay, Aaron? Why are you a gay man? Why have you made that choice? You know what? That was rude. I'm sorry. I apologize. I don't know what came over me. So inappropriate. I don't know why I would say that. My next real question is... God, look at you. Look at how stupid you look. Get a haircut, you fucking piece of shit.
Oh, Snake, do you think that, like, love can, like, bloom on the battlefield and stuff? Do you think that that can happen, Snake?
Can love bloom on a battlefield? Love can bloom anywhere, Merle. Anytime, any place, people can fall in love with each other. And if you love someone, you have to protect them. To quote Helen Keller, The best and most beautiful things in the world cannot be seen nor touched, but felt by the heart. And to quote further a poem by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, "Ah, how skillful grows the hand that obeyeth love's command. It is the heart and not the brain that to the highest doth attain. And he who followeth love's behest far excelleth all the rest."
Oh, Snake, you're so philosophical and verbose.
Yeah, I'm pretty badass. Plus, I'm totally in the ladies' room and I'm not supposed to be.
Is this chamomile? You fucking bitch, I'm allergic! Okay, welcome back to the game time chat zone. My next guest is Happy Harry Parker. You don't look too happy to me, fag.
It's Partridge.
What?
It's Partridge, my last name. You said Harry Parker?
Well, it says Parker on the card, so you're Parker. Oh, wait, Partridge. Like that song. Come on, get happy. That song's gay. You're gay. Oh, I'm such a dick. So, it, says here you made some shit called, Salad Finger Adventures.
I made Chuck's New Tux.
Okay, so, everybody go check out Chucky Tux on Newgrounds.com. What the fuck is that, anyway?
It's a cartoon made by me. It was lucky enough to win Newgrounds Movie of the Year for 2008.
Yeah, well, obviously, that award doesn't have a whole lot of, validity to it. I mean, if they're giving it to you. Come on, get happy. Come on, get happy. Jeez, that is the loudest fucking clock. Dude, seriously, this is gonna be bad. Fucking exit out, close the window, go watch a fucking a Homestar Runner, Happy Tree Friends, I don't know, just get out. Hey losers, I'm Mickey the Dick. So the boss says I have to do a video game review for this episode, which, of course, as you can imagine, I am ecstatic about. But let's just get this shit over with. So the game I chose to review is The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess for the Wii. Yeah, yeah, I know what you're thinking, it's a Wii launch title that came out like 4 years ago. But it's a Zelda game, so it's just as good to review as anything, so let's just shut up and let me do this. I gotta tell you, right off the bat, I had problems with this game. For starters, I couldn't fit it in my Wii. I couldn't figure out what the problem was. I mean, aren't you just supposed to slide the disc in? No matter how I turned it, it wouldn't fit. This is just shoddy workmanship on Nintendo's part. Come on, Nintendo, get on your shit. You're the most successful game developer in the world, and you can't make a game that fits in your own system? God, talk about dropping the ball. So anyway, I eventually did figure out how to get the game going, which is weird because apparently I didn't even need the Wii. It didn't make a lick of sense, but honestly it's hard to complain because without the Wii, the game becomes extremely portable. I played it in my bed, in the bathtub, outside. Well, not outside, in the basement holodeck, but you get the idea. Usually with these portable games, you have to worry about the sun glaring on the screen or whatever, but for some reason that never was a problem for me. It was almost like the more sun it got, the easier it was to see. It also never ran out of battery, so I'm guessing it was solar powered or something? I guess that's pretty sweet. Now on to the actual game itself. Nintendo changed a lot of the Zelda formula for this one, which I personally didn't give a shit about, but you fags out there who like the old ones might not like this new one. For example, Link is now Ralph, Zelda is Simon, Ganondorf is Jack, the Skull Kid is Roger, and Navi is Piggy. The gameplay mostly consists of mini-games and side quests and shit like that, where you hunt pigs and stuff. There is a lot of reading, which I guess makes sense, because it's an RPG after all, and they didn't shell out for voice acting. The story is pretty good. I mean, it has some twists. I don't want to give away the ending, but let's just say don't get too attached to Navi. So yeah, I don't really know what else to say about it. It was pretty good, but it had some flaws. I give it a 6 out of 10. Okay. I'll bite. What? Do you want June?
That's not a video game.
Oh my god, what?
That's not a video game. That's one of those things where it's like a bunch of pieces of paper all glued together. And also there's like the papers have like words on them, I think.
Yeah, that's like one of those story paper things where it's like a story on paper. Usually there's not a lot of gameplay, and when there is, the controls aren't very responsive.
You guys are retarded faggots. This is obviously a video game. You can tell by the polygons.
Polygons?
Yeah, look, count them up. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 polygons. Wait a minute, 4 polygons? This game has horrible graphics. What the fuck, Nintendo? Get your shit together. Quit making games with bad graphics, you jerks.
Well, you give this game a 6 out of 10, but I do not. I give it a 5 out of 50 because you can't even play as Super Mario Man, and I want to play as Super Mario and his brother, Louie, because Louie is my favorite video game guy, and I like Louie.
Eric, you can just go ahead and stop tape because we're not going to use any of this. What are you doing?
Pawn to pawn d5.
There was a different piece there a minute ago. What happened?
Yeah, my horse. But I moved it to c1. You said that the horses make L shapes.
okay, first of all, it's not a horse. It's called a knight, you Philistine. Second of all, the only L here is you.
Oh wow, that's real mature. I haven't heard that since, like, the third grade.
Oh yeah? Oh yeah? Well, what do you think of this?
Ow! I don't like you, Mickey.
You're not supposed to.
Ow, Mickey, stop it!
Ho 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 ho, now you're dead. Get up. Get up so I can hit you again. You're gonna get up, I'm gonna hit you again, you're gonna fall down again, and then I'm gonna tell you to get up so I can hit you again. Oh, you faggot ass piece of shit. I hate video games.
Would help you, Sonic. I am the third revelation. I am who the Lord has chosen. I'm smarter than you.
Wait, no.
I'm older, and I'm wiser.
I am your own friend, please.
You are nothing but a false prophet.
Help me,
sniveling boy.
Please, somebody.
I am the third revelation. I am the third revelation. I told you I would eat you. I told you I would eat you up!
We're brothers! Please, we're brothers! God. Please, please, forgive me. I beg
you
for forgiveness, please!
That's it! That's it!
Yeah.
I'm finished!
Actually, you know what? Hold on.
Ow, Mickey!
Okay, now I'm finished. What are you doing?
I'm rocking out.
This is rocking out to you? Okay, yeah. That's what rocking out looks like. Okay.
God, what a dick.
You're the one who's acting like a dick!
You want to know about rocking out? Everything you need to know about rocking out is right here.
Fuck yeah, psychic surgery rules!
That's the name of my band. Psychic surgery. Skate or die. Skate or die. Skate or die. Die, 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 die.
Yeah, this is Game Chat.
Hello and welcome to the Game Chat Zone Time. Today my guest is Tom Phalps, CEO of game development company The Behemoth and creator of popular Xbox Castle Smash and the founder of Newgrounds.com. We're going to be talking to him a little bit later, but first here's a message from our sponsors. Hi, I'm internet video game guy Mickey the Dick. Do you like video games? Don't fucking answer that, you idiot. I know you do. When you play video games, do you say to yourself,
"Duh, I like the video game, but I wish when I played the video game, there was a way to play a video game while I played the video game."
Well, get your hand off your dick, retard, because I've got something that's gonna blow you the fuck away. Check this shit out, fag. Video Game Hero. It's a video game where you play video games. I don't know how they make it. They got fucking pixels and polygons. They put the pixels in the polygons. I don't know. There's computers involved, but trust me, you want this shit. How does it work? Well, just grab a hold of our innovative video game controller-shaped game controller peripheral. We got buttons on buttons.
I just got the high score. That's right.
Check out this awesome testimonial from an incredibly intelligent girl gamer.
You may think that I'm not good at video games because I'm a girl, but no. And if you don't believe me, then I will play you at Brawl and beat you. And you probably think that I play as Peach because I'm a girl, but no. I play as Marth because I think he's cute. TXD!
Will you buy it? Fuck yeah, you'll buy it. You love video games. You rub video games all over your cock when you jack off.
Oh, it feels so right.
Order now. Or don't. I don't care.
Yeah, this is Game Talk.
Okay, and we are back at the Talk Game Talk Show time. We're here with Tom Philp, creator of Stewgrounds.com. Tom, did you know that I am in a band? Check this shit out. I bet you feel stupid now. What's your favorite Beatles song, Tom? Mine is, "Hey, hey, we're the Beatles. People say we beetle around."
Mickey, I don't think they did that one.
Fuck you, they did that one. They did that one. You know what? Just fuck you. Why do you have to come in here every day and just be the way that you are? You're all like, look at you. Look at how ugly you are. You're such a faggot. Tom, don't you think Eric's probably gay? So Tom, how did you get into game development?
I got into the game industry because I really just enjoyed everything about games. Not just playing them, but also watching them and studying the
graph. I'm sorry, unfortunately, we are out of time. Tom, it was great having you on. Everyone should check out his website, uglyretardedfaggots.com. One last thing I just wanted to touch on, Tom. I heard that you think that the Holocaust is funny. Why would you think that, Tom? Why would anybody think that? Why would anybody think anything like that? There's nothing funny about the Holocaust, Tom.
I read this episode myself, so you know it's good!
Okay, now what's this all about?
Eric left the cake out, which I told him not to do because we got bad ants. And June keeps taking my chapstick out of my locker, and that really gets me PO'd.
He keeps hugging it, I need it too!
And Eric said that I like Panic at the Disco, but really he's the one who likes Panic at the Disco.
No, you like Panic at the Disco.
No, you like Panic at the Disco.
No, you like Panic at the Disco. Alright, shut up the lot of ya. Now listen, I hate Panic at the Disco as much as the next guy. But you three are supposed to be a team. You gotta get along and work together and make video game videos or whatever.
Haven't done that in a while.
Eric and June, will you please step outside? Me and Mickey need to have a private conversation.
He fucking loves Panic at the Disco. He plays it all day long. Nice clock. Did your grandfather give you that?
No.
I'm gonna do it. Do you remember how mad this used to make you? I'd smash this lamp and you'd scream and scream and scream. I want to get back there. I want to get back to us.
You know what I think, Mickey?
What's that, sweetie?
I think that the only reason that you're a dick is because you like the reaction it elicits in people.
So you got it all figured out. The wheels are spinning in that little pea brain of yours, and you've been doing some cranial articulating, and now you think you know me. Also, you think I'm a dick? I'm hurt. I'm hurt, dude. I'm hurt that you think that. Sharp darts, my friend. Sharp darts being thrown betwixt us.
Mickey, all I want from you is compliance. I'm not asking you to like video games. I just want you to make this damn show.
And what's my incentive?
You will earn my respect.
Knock, knock. Who's there? Saliva.
Get out.
And you know what else he said to me? He said the only reason I'm a dick is because I like to piss people off. Man, what a fucking asshole.
Well?
Well, what?
Don't you just be a dick to piss people off?
Fuck no. I'm a dick because I'm a no-good street punk rebel without a cause who calls no man mister because that's how I roll. See, you fags let the man keep you down, but that shit ain't me, yo.
Yeah, okay, Mickey. Okay.
You don't say that to me! That's my thing to say to you! And everybody else! Because everybody else is retarded! You got that?
So say it. I'm waiting.
I hate video games!
Mickey, why do you hate video games so much?
Because video games are video gay. They are head-up-the-ass retarded. Here, look at this Metal Gear Solid 4 sketch we did last week.
War has changed.
And now look at this Fallout 3 sketch we did yesterday.
War never changes.
See? They all think they're making poignant philosophical statements, but really they're just filled with overly poetic, shallow, interchangeable garbage.
Well, Mickey, even though you hate video games, God's greatest gift to mankind and the sole reason the universe was created.
We just want to let you know that we accept you for who you are, and you don't have to put on a tough guy front around us.
Hey, that's great, but last time I checked, I hate you, and I hate you. So if you'll excuse me, I need to get away from the both of you, and please stop following me.
Call it a hunch, but I'm beginning to suspect that Mickey might not be a nice guy.
Hey, guess what? I like that you don't like my show. Hey, fags and faggots. I'm Mickey the Penis. So usually in this show, me and the two retards dress up like video game guys, or I interview someone and I mean to them and it's so damn funny. But the other day I got this letter and I kind of wanted to talk about it on the show. This letter is from Robert Burgless. Robert writes, "Dear Mikey, for a show called Wacky Game Jokes for Kids, not only is your show not appropriate for kids because it has a lot of swearing, but it's also not really wacky and you guys don't really make jokes about video games. Mostly it's just you being mean to Jane and Eric." Okay, Robert, you want video game jokes? You got video game jokes!
Hey, June.
Yeah, Eric?
Why is Final Fantasy VI afraid of Final Fantasy VII?
Why?
Because Final Fantasy VII sold more copies in Japan and North America. Hey, Link, is it true that you use a boomerang to kill enemies?
Yeah, I couldn't remember how to throw a boomerang at first, but eventually it came back to me. So, Samus, how did you become a bounty hunter?
I used to be a banker, but I lost interest.
Hey, June.
Yeah, Eric?
Did you know Tetris was created in Russia?
Really?
Yeah, and you know what they say about people who are Russian.
What's that, Eric?
Slow down, you got plenty of time.
Hey, Companion Cube, is it true that the cake is a lie?
Well, you know what they say, cake r squared.
No, pie, Companion Cube, pie r squared.
Oh, does that mean the pie is a lie too?
So Samus, what did you do after you quit banking?
After that, I became a math teacher, but that job came with a lot of problems.
Hey, June.
Yeah, Eric?
Did you know Solid Snake has 5 penises?
Really?
Yeah, his condom fits like a glove. Hey, Mickey, did you ever notice that in Mario, when Mario eats a mushroom, it makes him grow bigger, but in real life, mushrooms don't do that?
Well, I always knew Mario was a fun guy. Princess Peach, I'm afraid you need an organ transplant.
Can you perform the surgery, Dr. Mario?
Sorry, I can't. I just don't have the guts. Are we clear?
Yeah, that's a take.
Thank God I can finally get this stupid mustache off. So damn itchy.
Yeah, this wig is itchy too. I'll probably just dye my hair next time.
I would think dyeing your hair would be more work, but whatever.
So what now?
I'm going down to the cafeteria. You guys can do whatever you want.
So we're done?
Yeah, I think that was implied when we finished.
Yeah, I mean, I just didn't know if you wanted to,
To what?
I don't think what we have is,
What we just filmed?
Yeah, I mean, everything that we have today, not just that scene.
What's wrong with it?
I didn't like it either.
Are we gonna rewrite it? Was this, like, the first draft or something?
No, this is the show. What we just did.
Yeah, we could workshop ideas and come up with something.
Yeah, and then what? Then we have to shoot it all again. Absolutely not.
Why not?
It's 7 o'clock.
We could come back tomorrow.
Tomorrow's Sunday.
So?
It's the Sabbath. I'm not doing shit tomorrow. I'll tell you that much right now. I am not doing shit tomorrow.
I don't think this episode was funny at all.
Yeah, who cares? None of them are funny, you idiot.
If we work super fast, we could finish before lunch tomorrow.
I don't like working on Sunday either, but if we
do a rewrite
as fast as we can, and if we really power through it tomorrow...
Okay, you guys aren't fucking listening to me. I don't give a shit about whether or not you think this episode is funny. I don't care.
I don't even want to have my name on something that I don't feel like it meets my par of quality.
Par of quality? You have a par of quality?
Do you really want to just put this out?
Okay, what you don't fucking understand, because you're too fucking dense to listen to me and to listen to what I'm saying, is I have... The boss gave me a quota of content that I have to produce every day, or a set amount of hours that I have to film, and I work from 9 to 5, and it's already fucking 7. It's fucking 7, so the show is done.
Well, you can just leave the camera on and let it record nothing, but that doesn't mean that you made an episode.
I don't care if you don't like this episode. Newsflash, dipshit. I don't like any of the episodes. Nobody cares. Nobody's watching this show. The internet already fucking hates it. They're all watching some fucking Eagle Raptor or Mega 64 bullshit. I don't know. Nobody's watching this show.
I don't think you know what you're doing.
Are you trying to fucking start some shit with me?
Okay, guys, I guess the easiest thing for us to do would just be to not do a reshoot. So, Eric, maybe we could just let this one go.
I don't understand how you
all of a sudden feel like you can talk to me like that.
I don't like the direction this conversation is going in, and I think we should just all go our separate ways before someone gets even madder than they already are.
Eric, I don't know if you realize this. I'm fucking insane, okay? Do you have the fucking mental capacity to fucking understand what I will do to you? You need to watch your fucking mouth, is what you need
well,
to do.
Well, maybe it's
okay?
not your position to say what you will and won't do while you work here, because you don't have a choice in the matter. And I'm sure the boss would be very interested to know that you're not putting in the effort into the content that we produce, and the show is suffering because of it.
I don't think you're grasping the reality of the situation! Oh, there goes the lamp. It was a pretty good lamp, but oh well. Oh, what's this? $3,000 HD video camera? Well, that's gonna be broken. This is gonna be broken. All this shit's gonna be broken.
Okay, Mickey, you know what? Don't if the boss is gonna be mad if you break all of his
equipment again. Get the fuck away from me. I will smash your fucking head open. I don't give a fuck.
Your own call security.
Do I dial 9 first?
Oh, I don't care. Call them. Tell them to come here.
I know if you dial 9 first, okay? I don't know. Look, just try dialing it without dialing 9 first.
I
will show you how fucking crazy I am. You don't believe that I'm crazy. I will show you how crazy I am. Does this seem crazy to you? Am I crazy yet? Do you believe me now?
Why does it have to be on my responsibility?
You know what? Forget it. Let's just get out.
Get out. Get the fuck out of here! Get out! Get the fuck out! Get out! Hope you liked it, Robert!
This is the worst episode we've ever made.
It's really not that worse than the other ones.
Disclaimer, this episode is incredibly stupid.
Hi, I'm Mickey.
And I'm June.
And we want you to come on down to Mick and June's Discount Brawl Confirmation Warehouse. We're confirming characters left and right. Super Mario, Super Linkio, fuck those fags, they're gay.
They're totally gay.
So who are we confirming?
Sonical Hedgeman?
Confirmed for Brawl!
Pokemon Aficionado?
Confirmed for Brawl!
Sal the Snake?
Confirmed for Brawl!
We got every animal you can think of. Hedgehogs, snakes, foxes, wolves, gorillas, falcons, falcos.
But we're not done yet!
Banji Kazoople, confirmed for Brawl!
Bombi Man, confirmed for Brawl!
Morgan Freeman, confirmed for Brawl!
Terry Touchy, confirmed for Brawl!
Yo dog, check it out, we got
Friend Box!
Bazooka Joe, confirmed for Brawl.
Brian Bassane, confirmed for Brawl.
Milhouse, confirmed for Brawl.
Homestar Runner, confirmed for Brawl.
Aaron Insurance, confirmed for Brawl. Captain Kirk, confirmed for Brawl. Captain Picard, Captain Antoniel, Captain Planet, Captain Crunch, Captain Morgan, Captain Kangaroo.
Acid Reflux Disease, confirmed for Brawl.
God, the creator and ruler of the universe, confirmed for Brawl. Look, I gotta tell you, he's a little overpowered. Frankly, I think some of the tournaments are gonna want to have him banned. We got Ryu, we got Ken, we got Chun-Li, Zangief, M. Bison, Sagat, Jack, Kate, Locke, Sawyer, Saeed, Hurley, they're all in Brawl. We're also selling DVDs. All your favorite TV shows and movies. Monsters Brawl, Brawl in the Family, Brawl the King's Men, Brawl House Season 1. We got Base Brawl, we got Basket Brawl, we got Foot Brawl. We call it soccer here in America. You might call it football.
If you're a faggot.
But that's not Brawl. If you brawl in the next 10 minutes, you'll receive
2,500 paperclips.
Brawl now! Operators are standing by.
So come on down to Mick and June's.
It beats getting a kick in the brawls.
Mick and June's Discount Brawl Confirmation Warehouse. We're straight up brawlin'! We're right off Route 5!
This might be funnier if Brawl didn't come out 2 years ago.
Who cares?
This show is really going downhill.
You can't go downhill when you start at the bottom of the hill, you nitwit. Hi, I'm Mickey the Dick. Welcome to the fan mail special. Well, Eric, how many nudes from Hot Babes did we get?
None. Zero nudes.
Are you serious? God damn it. Why are women so reluctant to send naked photos of themselves to strangers over the internet? I am very disappointed in all of you. Well, we got a lot of emails to get through, so let's get going. First email comes from Sean Simon. Sean writes, Dear Mickey, what is your favorite video game? Or rather, since you hate video games, what video game do you least hate? Wow, this is the first one and it's already retarded. What part of I hate video games don't you dipshits understand? Well, I hope the next one's better. Dear Mickey, fuck you. From Eric. Now this is interesting, he claims to be Eric, but you can clearly see his return address says his name is Vincent Fahm, and his email address is super_snowman123@hotmail.com. Yeah, so nice try, idiot. Next email. Dear Mickey T. Dick, what makes VGV so evil? Thus far, their only act of evil is taking a knife-wielding crook off the streets and forcing him into a career that causes him nothing but grief. Seems more like karma than an act of evil. Sincerely, Keith. VGV is a company that makes video game comedy for the internet. That seems pretty evil to me. Next email. This one comes from Dan. Dan writes, Dear Mickey, I would like to know your views on this age-old question. Pirates or ninjas? Zombies would also be an acceptable answer. Good luck, Dan. Wow, Dan, you're so funny. You must be the life of the party everywhere you go. I really want to hang out with you. Next email. Robbie writes, Dear Mickey, the only reason I wrote this is to waste your time. I'm going to murder you. I'm going to come into your house one night while you're asleep. I'm going to cut your throat. This isn't a joke. You're going to die. Next email. Why is June so dumb and punch that nerd guy for me? Because he's asking for it. Look at him. Also take another sip of beer. Cheers. Okay, that was a good email. I like that one. Next email comes from Trosman. Let's see what this guy has to say. For an above-average intellectual who's mentally surpassed your inferior-minded companions by an expansive margin, you seem to distinguish your aggressive emotions in a rather harsh, but completely immature and insufferably childish manner. You also seem to feed on other people's reactions to your implied actions, which is easily comparable to an emotionally distraught schoolyard bully. Is it true that you are what you say you are, or are you just trying too hard on covering your paper-thin persona of a generic street rebel in order to attempt to impose a decent threat to your companions in a flawed deliberation to achieve mild social dominance to feel something other than hatred about yourself? Sincerely, Trosman. Go eat a grilled dick sandwich, you faggot. Next email. Charlotte writes, Dear Mickey, I think you are a complete dick, which upon this I admire you for. Plus, the Mario and Sonic fight made me pee my pants laughing. Ew. Eric deserved it, the dumb a-hole. Please give me some pointers on how to be a dick, just like you. From Charlotte. I'm sorry, Charlotte, but girls aren't allowed to be dicks. Those are just the rules. You can be a bitch. Let me know how that works out for you. Next email. Dear Mickey, it seems plainly obvious that you absolutely despise video games. I have a friend that never shuts the hell up about video games, and he always tells me about the newest game that I just gotta get. But I never listen to whatever he says. So here's my question. What can I do to make him stop talking about these retarded games that I just don't care about? Please enlighten me. Yours sincerely, Jack Evans. P.S. Will you punch Eric in the face for me? I laugh every time you physically hurt him. You want your friend to stop talking about video games and you think it's funny when people get punched in the face. I think you just answered your own question. The next email is from Tyler. Tyler says, I realize that June bears a striking resemblance to June from the old Nickelodeon show Kablam! Both have blue hair, both are named June, and both are on shows that host sketches and whatnot. Well, June, what do you think? Are you secretly June from Kablam?
Sure.
There you have it. Next email. This one's from Matt. Matt writes, Have you ever been so far even as decided to use go want to look more like... What the fuck? Matt, proofread your emails, you dumbass. Next email comes from Fabio Richardson. Mickey the Dick, how big is your dough? Okay, well, that's inappropriate. Next email. Dear Mickey, did you have a girlfriend before you came to VGV? Sincerely, Chris. No way, dude. Love is for the simple-minded. I don't need no dames.
Then how come you wanted them to send you naked pictures?
Shut up! Dear fuckface, if you hate the show so much, then why don't you just quit? Sincerely, Dawson. Now, I wouldn't have normally answered this question because it's retarded, but unfortunately, I got this question a million times.
Why don't you just, like, walk out the front door? Why don't you just quit? Why don't you just leave? Why don't you just leave? Why don't you just leave? Why don't you just leave?
Because it will explode. Perimeter-sensitive exploding ankle bracelet. It's been there the whole time. Prove it hasn't. Is that a sufficient enough answer for you? What is wrong with you nerds? Why do you have to nitpick everything? If the premise of my situation is that I'm trapped, then I'm trapped. If you know what the definition of trapped is,
then logically, you can infer that something is keeping me here. Maybe the windows are quadruple pane. Maybe they have robot guards. Maybe they have security cameras watching my every move.
Oh, fuck, I peed on my shirt.
Did any of this occur to any of you? I think the real question is, why haven't any of you morons come to bust me out yet? I'm broadcasting this live on the internet. You can see me, right? Next email. Jeez! Dear Mickey, I think inside you are full of fluffy kittens and double rainbows and you probably just need a hug. Sincerely, me.
Next email.
Dear Mickey, why do you always have bags under your eyes? Edward Kaj, Director, Machinima, Inc. http://www.machinima.com. Why did you go so out of your way to let me know you're the director of Machinima.com? Why did you think I would care? I don't give a fuck about your shitty website and its shitty content. Sheesh. Get a life, you loser. Next email. This one comes from Jenna. Jenna writes, your pants. Take them off. See? It's still there. Next email. Yesterday, my friend called me gay, so I played along and admitted to it. Now everybody thinks I'm gay. Did I make the right choice? From Chris Harmon. No. Unless you want people to think you're gay, you fucked up. Idiot. The next email is from Lauren. Lauren writes, dear Mickey, how come you are such a dick? Is it because your mother didn't love you enough?
You don't know shit about my mother.
Dear Mickey, how come Eric has antennae? Eric?
I'm a robot.
There you go, he's a robot. Next question. Dear Mickey, I was wondering what was your most favorite video game character of all times, and could you cosplay as him or her in this episode? Thank you for doing my question. From Wallace, age 9. I can't make fun of a 9-year-old. I'm being facetious, obviously. Of course I can make fun of a 9-year-old. Fuck you, Wallace. 9-year-olds are gay. Next email comes from Logan. Logan writes, dear Mickey, my question is, was there ever a time when you were not a dick? I am the biggest dick that you'll ever meet. I've always been a dick, and I'll always be a dick. And that's all you need to know.
You know what? I think that's enough mail. Let's look at some fan art. Eric, throw some of that shit up on the screen. Okay, let's see what we got here. Okay, well, this asshole's just showing off. We're not gonna look at that. Let's go to the next one. This dude totally got my physique right. This guy got the right idea, too. Except, you know, like I said earlier, I don't need no dames. This guy drew me like a black dude, I guess. I got, like, black features. I'm not black. Do you people know what I look like? Okay, this guy drew me like a midget. I'm also not a midget. I'm a very tall man. Let's see what else we got here. Okay, we got some more assholes showing off. I don't want any of that shit. What the fuck is this anime shit? Get that off the screen. I don't want to look at that. Okay, this one sucks. This one sucks. Okay, this guy must be poor if he's drawn on lined paper. This one sucks. This one sucks. This one is just creepy. I don't want to look at that. This one was drawn with menstrual blood, I guess. That's disgusting. Ew! Why are me and June hugging in this one? I wouldn't hug June with a gun to my head. Not in a million years would I do that. Okay, let's look at the next one. Okay, this one sucks, this one sucks, this one sucks, this one sucks, 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 sucks. This one I like. Sucks, 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 sucks. This one I like, this one sucks. This is me if I was in a video game, I guess. What the fuck is this? This isn't even discernible to me as an image of something. This is just scribbles.
What the hell? These all suck! I'm not sitting here bottomless in a room with a couple of Robert Burglesses just to look at crappy art from fans that I hate. Eric, I had better see some good fucking fan art on the screen right now!
Okay. Well, I'm over it. You know what? If you guys aren't going to take this seriously, then I'm just not even going to do the show anymore.
So, I love your show. My boyfriend and I watch it every time there's a new episode. We both have you subscribed on Twitter, and I subscribed on YouTube. We even have the theme song for the show as our ringtones and on our iPods. We'd love to be on your show one day, even just one of us. I mean, we love your show so much, we're going as you guys for Halloween. I'm going to be June, and he's not sure if he wants to be you or Eric. Hope you respond. I'd love it. Love, Tony Klong. P.S. We're getting shirts from the site, too.
Boy, what a couple of fucking losers.
I'm stuck behind the title card. It won't open.
Hi, I'm Mickey the Dick. And tonight, on a very special episode, Wacky Game Jokes for Kids, Top 10 Hottest Game Chicks. Counting down the list. Number 10, Candy Kong. I quit.
Can he do that?
I'm not sure. He's gonna get in trouble.
Will Mickey the Dick please report to the editor's office, please?
Ooh.
June and Eric, too.
Aww.
This is the last straw, Mickey. I'm tired of this insubordination.
Yeah, I'll bet.
What makes you think that you have the authority to quit?
Okay, listen. I know you're fucking retarded, so I'll say this slowly so you can understand me. And please, listen to me with every scrap of brain cell that you have in that Neanderthalian skull. Wacky Game Jokes for Kids is done. It's over. Just because you won't let me go doesn't mean that you can make me keep doing this.
It's Wacky Game Jokes for Kids. It's spelled with a Z.
Okay, well, you're not listening.
Do you have any idea how infuriating it is to be an indentured servant for a company that forces you to humiliate yourself every day on a worldwide scale?
Boy, Mickey, you sure do complain a lot. What?
You're not going anywhere, Mickey. You're gonna stay right here, and you're gonna keep doing videos.
Boss, can I tell you a secret?
What kind of secret?
A secret secret.
Okay.
Okay, but you gotta lean in close so I can whisper it in your ear. This is a super secret secret. Little closer. Little closer. Little closer. Almost there. And that's good.
Video games aren't funny!
I've been here since January. That's 10 months of my life gone. I only did your faggy little dog and pony show for this long because I thought that if I did, you'd let me go. But it has been made painfully clear that that's not going to happen. So I quit. I don't care if you have the robots kill me. I'm not doing it anymore. So what do you think of that?
This is what I think of that.
Aw, that's cute.
Hey guys, where you going? Come on, we're having a gun party in here. We're all gonna hang around and point guns at each other.
I didn't want it to come to this, Mickey. Just do the show.
Nah, I don't feel like it.
Look around, Mickey. You're not in the position to be calling the shots here.
Okay, look, I was a criminal. I robbed liquor stores, I sold crack, I stole car stereos, and yes, I've had guns pointed at me.
Do the show, Mickey. The internet wants to know who your top 10 hottest game chicks are.
You're not gonna pull that trigger. I can totally see it in your eyes.
I'll do it, Mickey.
Prove it.
Kill me. Kill me right now. I'd rather be dead than spend one more minute of my life cracking jokes about Master Chief. Do it! Do it! Kill me! Kill me!
I knew it. The German Walther PPK 7.65 semi-automatic. First released in 1939, they were issued to high-ranking German officials in World War II. In 1945, Adolf Hitler shot himself with this very model. Modern retail price, $1,135. But ironically enough, no better at killing a man than any other gun. You're just like June and Eric. They think I'm a joke? But you know what? They don't know who I am. They don't know about the things that I've seen and the things that I've done. I'm the real deal.
Bored.
Hey, Mickey, are you bored?
Do you want to come play video games with us?
No!
Jeez, where have you guys been?
Mickey, I'm sorry that you're a slave, but you still have us. We'll always be your friends.
I don't want to be friends with you.
Oh.
Mickey, do you ever wonder why you were kidnapped by VGV?
What do you mean?
Like, it could have been anybody. There are hundreds of crooks in New York.
So, like, why me specifically?
Yeah.
No, I never wonder that.
Really? How come?
Because I know why.
Okay, I'm recording this from my phone. All right, bye.